Today is the start of what will probably be my last big adventure. I can no longer climb the Monroes, but there is a humble hill on the Isle of Harris I hope to summit with the last of my darling little dog Tashi Laz Dust. His last gift to me was my companion for this sacred journey, my darling little Pixie Belle, or the auspicious wisdom pixie, as I now call her. My dear wee mammy is also with us, and without her, there would be no journey. We went up and down a few of the little hummocks, taking loads of pictures, and they were bothering. A lovely day down here in the Eugen sky. We've arrived at the ferry terminal where we get the boat over to the island of Paris this afternoon. So Eugen itself has got quite a number of things you can do if you're here, but obviously if you have a dog then you're kind of limited with that. But Pixie's been very well behaved, and we had a lovely time visiting the Perry Glen this morning. In Norton, we're out for a meander along towards the machair near Ceapabhal. The view to the hills of North Harris is fabulous, and it's just such a beautiful deepening silence. Can I hear with more detail without all the background ambience and noise that we have daily in the fixer. I don't really want to say too much because it just spoils the moment almost. But Ceapabhal, I can say an easier route up, which Sitski, Suzanne's daughter, had confirmed earlier on today. So if there is anyway, I'm going to get Pixie up there, it will be in slow stages, and rather than head on assault, we'll make our way over to the right and then just slowly go up the easier angled ridge to the summit. Anyway, that would be the plan should it happen. Much will be up to the auspicious wisdom pixie.
Pixie girl.
I had wanted to climb the minor eminence above Puffin Cottage on that first morning, but the auspicious wisdom pixie had other ideas. We still had a great view though.
Girl, does she want to come for a walkie? Yeah, we can go and see the sunset. Have a nice walkie, that'll be lovely, girl. Look at her big eyelashes. Beach at Norton, there's another couple further on, and there's the ruins of an old temple. Which might be what we visit if we don't get to the summit of Ceapabhal, which of course is going to be down to the auspicious wisdom, Pixie, if she's coming along. Yeah, and as usual. And this is a lovely little beach. As for better than this, I'm wearing my Harris tweed jacket. What a beach, eh? Look at the colour of that sea.
Pixie girl!
Plainly.
Pixie! That's a good girl. Yeah, were you going off to try and get some scrounging food, eh? I guess I've always been open to the sacred and the magical universe, although I didn't always see it in Glasgow. A friend once told me that you can only walk the path of the Zolchempa alone. For years I resisted this path, until I was left with no other choice.
Here's a girl. The mountains have disappeared entirely from view. Yeah. for a bit. It's an okay day, it's quite dry, but quite windy, which I think will act as a deterrent for Pixie. And the last few days have proved that she's much more of a beach babe than a mountain lion. So not wanting to prejudge things too much, I think we might well end up visiting a few of the beaches along the western coast, I think it is. Okay, well, we'll see. You can never tell with Miss Pixie. There's someone coming along. So she's spotting them. Hey Pixie. Yeah. We're looking along the huge big dunes here. Structures that separate Ceapabhal from becoming an island in its own right. Considerable distance to go, and not thinking Pixie's too keen. Are you, Pixie? Doesn't really matter. Yeah. Orchid. It's a cannon or something plunging down into the water there, it's flying just across. It's quite a big bird, but the Pixie girl, you're loving the sheep shit. You enjoying that? Oh, big sneeze. Don't get yourself all covered in that now. At least you're not eating a lot of Tashi. Would you like some gammon, Pixie?
Pixie. Oh, the little Pixie girl.
Well, Pixie and I have had a absolutely wonderful Hebridean adventure. I'm not disappointed in the end that we didn't get to the summit of Ceapabhal. We've explored it on all sides and explored some wonderful beaches. And I think that the Pixie girl is more of a beach babe than she is a mountain lion. And that's fine. The same thing you see from here is just how easily all of this environment could change with the sea levels. This is us making our third visit to Luston Tower. Last week we had an absolutely gorgeous day. The sun was shining, it was absolutely beautiful. And then this morning, I was playing about with the GoPro, and I managed to delete 5 days of footage that I've been shooting.
Come on, Pixie.
It's been the Tibetan bathing place. There's a star, which is a rishi, which is visible at the moment. The Tibetans, they believe that rishi, very auspicious to bathe in waters at this time, because they become wish-fulfilling nectar.
It is said that the sands of Luskentyre were once made of grains of gold. But a greedy man filled his boat with this very gold, and then sold it at the market on the mainland. The fairies cannot abide such greed, and they caused a great storm to rise, which destroyed many boats. They also turned the golden beach back to sand, but once a year, at sunset, they change it back again. As a reminder.
Day trying to reshoot all the footage that I inadvertently deleted this morning. A couple of key locations didn't manage to get to.
Oh, ще марок із нянь ян сарах поян фас. А смярк не гекеш скері каренку ашт. Кахуней керев на Ci sono riav mon via scavirish e aske na sfial kak shar ser kremech ve ma dosan vas vers shto im dikre amun yela
Oh, you love the beach, eh?
When I was a younger man, I lived in an illusory world of certainties. Certainties that good things would happen, bad things would sometimes happen too. Certainties that I would go on a holiday every year, we'd explore some new and exciting place, that there would always be new horizons and things to do, if only we took the time to do them. But the truth of the matter is, as the COVID-19 pandemic has made only too evidently clear, we are mortal beings and we can take nothing for granted. We are given no certainties. Beach with Pixie, who is once again busy playing in the sand, aren't we, Pixie? But it's absolutely gorgeous today.
Yeah, it's a Pixie. Oh, there she comes, slow coach Pixie. Eh? Never in a hurry. Pixie!
I have tried to live and act with loving kindness in my heart. And I have often failed, but I keep trying. In this now, I am just a collection of my memories and the karmic traces I will leave behind me when my time has come to pass from this life. There is only to now. Everything else is samsara, a creation of mind. The not I has tasted the truth of the Dharma in visions, dreams, and altered states of consciousness. I practice daily. It may not be enough. Zogchen is a secret teaching, and in the Tibetan tradition it can only be transmitted by the mind of an authentic master. My task is as thought succeeds thought, to avoid clinging to any of them. This is called taming the mind.
Pixie, never mind going over there.
I had hoped to take a little of Tashi Lal's dust to the summit of Ceapabhal. But at best, the auspicious wisdom pixie is a reluctant mountaineer. The hills brought out a wild joy in Tashi. He always ran ahead of me, and then waited for old two legs to catch up, just so he could regard me with his absolute disdain.
Shells, and there's now a little bit of them shall be forever here on Skarista Beach, the mountains of North Aris. Of course, the sacred hill, Ceapabhal, on a wonderful Sunday in August, with its warm and the breeze. Salad, the wee Pixie's a good girl, protecting the rucksack, sand all over her face again.
The auspicious wisdom Pixie is not an aspiring pack leader. She prepares to follow in my heels, but like all Apsos, she can be stubborn. Now, if you try to dominate an Apso, you will most likely fail. Encouragement, love, and undying admiration will win their hearts and their trust.
Taking off my socks and shoes. This is actually going to be the first time I've ever went and paddled in the sea. So it's a little beachy at North Dunsick. Pixie is sitting down. He is rather cold, I have to say. I wouldn't like to swim in it, and my feet are getting quite cold now, but there we go.
I have to say, the midges have been a wholly unwelcome revelation.
Pixie, come on.
The Hebridean wind ensured Generalissimo Attila's vampire squadrons remained grounded during my autumn and spring visits to Harris. Not so this summer. For the past 5 nights, the wind has dropped to the barest whisper. And then Puffin Cottage is surrounded by Attila's ravenous plague hordes. I have slain many of their number. But the auspicious wisdom Pixie has complete disregard for my strict midge protocols. And I fear she may well be my Trojan horse. The horror. The horror. Midges. Pixie is an extremely sociable little dog, and she has willfully flouted social distancing regulations throughout the pandemic. I, of course, endeavour to curb her enthusiasms, but often to no avail. The young adventure surfers from Lewis ignore her.
Don't you go. The sea's gonna get you.
I'd say Pixie considers herself to be my game. She is, of course, much sweeter than me, and much more sociable. I dreamed I saw wee Tash last night, alive as you and me. Says I, but Tash, you're near 2 years gone. Says he, I never died. Says he, I never died. I have one certainty about the auspicious wisdom pixie. She is a part of my life because of Tashi. I see her through his wise old eyes, and I love her no less than I love Tashi. Losing my little mountain lion was the hardest thing I have ever faced. Pixie brought sunshine back into my life.
Selfish parking in the parking area, I have to say. Other people could have got parked here quite easily, but a van has taken up three spaces.
Oh, you are a moany old bugger, David.
And I just hope you're getting that wonderful view behind. It's absolutely stunning up here in the hills of North Harris. Well, up in North Harris here, taking a walk into the Eagle Observatory. As usual, she's finding smells to be interested in. It's 2 kilometres to the Eagle Observatory. Now, we should make that easily, Pixie. Come on, Pixie, never mind that. There'll be plenty of interesting smells along the way. Well, I have to say the midges are absolutely terrible here. The breeze is dropping occasionally, which doesn't make it very comfortable. And at Pixie's pace, I'm afraid that getting there is going to take a long time. She herself doesn't seem to be bothered by midges.
I may not have climbed Ceapabhal, but I have been with her, and I have come to know her moods. Often the mountain gives itself most completely, when I have no destination, when I reach nowhere in particular, but have gone out merely to be with the mountain, as one visits a friend, with no intention but to be with him. Well, it's Monday. Tomorrow will be our last full day in the island, and we were going to go along to
Treig Rosamol, more commonly known as Luskentyre. But there was already lots of traffic heading down that way, so we ended up back at wonderful Scarissa. A little dog all on her own.
Hark as my lingering footsteps slow retire. Some spirit of the air has waked thy string. 'Tis now a seraph bold with touch of fire. 'Tis now the brush of the fairy's frolic wing. Receding now, the dying numbers ring. Fainter and fainter down the rugged dell. And now the mountain breezes scarcely bring a wandering witch note of the distant spell. And now 'tis silent.
This was the first beach I saw in Arras. Your first glimpse of it comes near the end of the road from Tarbert. In a simple twist of fate, today is my last on this beautiful island of light. I have no certainty of ever returning. I don't look too far ahead anymore. Dogs are only ever in the now. And like Yeshi Pixie, I am an old dog walking the crow road. Pixie has become my dog now, and our relationship has come a long way since our first visit to Harris. She is much more sociable than me, and Tashi Jomo for that matter. Like me, he was very selective about friends. Little Pixie has no such discrimination. And although she is very fond of me, unlike Tashi, I am not her life.
Well, it's our final day on the island of Arras, after 15 days of perfect solitude. And we're on our way to visit for the fourth time the beach where just about everybody comes to, because it's a really world famous beach. It's called Luskentyre, although actually it's really called Treig Rosamol. Well, most people Pixie's up to her usual sand things already. Every time you come here, it's slightly different. Well, indeed, the approach is different. There used to be a kind of river behind the cliff. I'm not sure if he's redirecting that in some way. It wasn't really a river, a little stream. But I've been here in wild autumnal weather. Beautiful autumnal weather. A day when you couldn't even see Darrensey. It was raining pretty hard, but nonetheless it was still majestic.
Pixie now listens to me when I talk to her, and often with complete concentration. Occasionally I do seem to bemuse her, and recently she has even yawned with a pained expression.
And there isn't much of a wind today, I have to say. Okay. It is. Don't seem to live in train much.
Enchanted.
Just sitting here taking in this wonderful view at Loscantyre now. Thank goodness we managed to get parked and came when we did. I had thought about going for an early lunch, but instead we'll go for a bit of a later lunch, and we've had Loscantyre Beach in beautiful conditions, as we said. Lots of lovely cloud about. Flying through as a seabird. We are only ever really in the now. It is all we have. I may be walking the Crow Road, but the dreamer has not given up on his last sacred hill.